I'd say the top thing that impressed me the most was, I suppose, look, I've been in Ballinasloe many times over the years, but to see it today and see how much it's changed over the last couple of years, the investment, let's say, in the streetscape for a start, and then the front of all the shop fronts have been all, well, most of them have been, we'd say, upgraded or got a facelift, if you like. So it's certainly, the town looks a whole lot better. There's no doubt about that. It's an amazing investment in it. Secondly to that, I suppose, the whole area of just, I suppose we were at the launch this morning of the Europe Direct in the library, and it was interesting to see all the community groups that were there, particularly the like of those community development, CLG, not-for-profit development company, then there was the leader company was there, the Northwest Regional Authority, I think, were represented as well, and all the different stakeholders, and you could see how they were effectively working together in the community. I think that's brilliant. Yeah. Like, particularly with the development group were doing, if you'd like, a town team type approach to it, where they were getting all the stakeholders in together and working together to identify what the issues were for the town, and then look at the options as whether they could get funding or whatever it would take to progress the different ideas. And I think that joined up thinking, that cooperation, the spirit of cooperation that you could see, is evident in the result that you see around Ballinasloe today.
Well, it's absolutely phenomenal. And Colm, you're absolutely right. That was BACD, and I think you got to meet Lynn Donnelly and Colm as well from BACD. And would you please shopballinasloe.ie? This is one of the great projects. Colm also had a chance to meet the Galway Rural Development team that the office is on Dunlow Street. And like one of the projects they funded was Christmas Lights. And we all know how well the town looked last year. And that was a fund of over 87,000. And they were working with the town team and the group here to develop that. Galway Rural Development as well, Colm. I mean, you met some of the team there.
Yeah, I do know. They're excellent. There's no doubt about it. And I think I heard figures of, I think it was 350,000 was spent in Ballinasloe alone by the company. And I think definitely what they do, I suppose, look, rural development is all about what it says in the tin. It's about rural communities and rural towns being looked after. And I suppose one of the frustrations I would have sometimes is that the like of the bigger cities or towns looking to access that fund. It's really for rural communities and places like Ballinasloe to help regenerate towns like this. The objective here has to be to take people off the roads commuting to the big cities like Galway or Dublin, and get the enterprise in the local town, and get the multiplier effect in the local town of people buying their coffees or working for the local, playing for the local football team or whatever the case may be. That regenerates a rural community, and the like of the leader companies and all the other support organisations that are there can play a massive part in helping that regeneration happen. And it's clear from talking to all the people in Ballinasloe that that is working and that is coming together with all the different stakeholders. And hopefully, going forward, that can only build into better and more. And hopefully, over the years coming, get better again.
It's really crucial. And I suppose what we have here with our MEP, and an MEP for the North West, I mean, we have Colm Markey, we have Maria Walsh, we have a number of MEPs that represent us here in the North West. We're very fortunate to have that link. And I suppose it's the importance of showing how important Europe is for us at a local level. Between the leader funding that's come in, 350,000, as you mentioned, that was for the town band hall building. It's also for the theatre, or for the town theatre as well. Apologies, guys. But we're also seeing the importance of this funding. I mean, but for us, the importance of Europe.
There's a lot of things going on at European level. I suppose at one level, you've all the things that people can't relate to. All the things about, let's say, European armies or corporation tax and all those things that are somewhat abstract. But there's an awful lot of things that we need to focus on that are down to the ordinary person on the ground, the likes of the vaccination programme.